realized that this part of the plan was not as well thought out, which, by the way, is really saying something. And so I said, all right, but you have to keep it a secret. I'm getting married tomorrow. And he said, you just broke up like a week ago. At which point I realized he didn't even know I'd started seeing Bonnie yet. So I said no, and I pulled the license out of my backpack and I showed it to him, and he laughed and laughed harder than I remember ever seeing him before laugh. He said, okay, you can come in at 11:30. So on Friday, October 29th, 2010, 1 week to the day after Bonnie and I had started dating, we got married at the Manhattan City clerk's office, surrounded by two of our kind of acquaintances. And then we went to work. And you know what? It was good. It was good for a while. There was a while there where, you know, we moved into that, you know, Alyssa and Adele, we moved into that small one-bedroom apartment on Classen Avenue in Brooklyn, and we cooked dinner with each other, and we went to parties together, and it was fun to introduce my wife, and, you know, it was fun to play house. And it lasted, and it was good for about 6.5 months, when she went to California to go visit her brother for about a week, and while she was gone, I got a text message that said, we need to talk. It was from Alyssa. And so I responded very curtly, what do you want? She told me that she had heard I was married, she thought it was crazy, but she was happy I was doing well. She told me that she was so sorry that she had hurt me both emotionally and physically. She told me that she missed me and she wanted, and she wished she could have done it differently. And then in a move of self-sabotage, so clear that it almost seems on purpose, I said, well, why don't you come over and have a drink? You know, as friends. I had never done anything like that before, and I've never done anything like that since. And the feeling of guilt that I woke up with the next morning and every day since has cut through me like a cancer. And when Bonnie came home, I told her what happened, and she told me that she loved me and that we could work through it. And I said, no. No. I didn't deserve her after that, and she didn't deserve what I had done to her, and that was it. I don't believe in regret a lot. I think that the mistakes that we make, they help us grow, we learn from them, and regret is usually a waste of time, but I regret that. Not because I think that Bonnie and I would have stayed together. There were a billion reasons why that would never have worked out. But because no one deserves that kind of betrayal. I didn't deserve it at Alyssa's hands, and she didn't deserve it at mine. And it was over. In New York, you can only get divorced if someone is willing to claim irreparable fault on the other party, or if you're separated for a year. Neither of us wanted to claim irreparable fault on the other party, so we filed for separation in June. And then the following June, our tan lines have faded from our ring fingers, and we kind of forgot about it. Well, I don't know if we forgot about it or if we're blocking it out. Probably the latter. And whenever we did remember, something came up financially or otherwise, and it took 3 more years before I found myself this past July at a Starbucks in Times Square being served divorce papers while a woman outside was passing out flyers in body paint for a 4th of July sale. I don't know why it took me that long to finalize it. I think that it's because I needed to grow up first. I think it's because I needed to be the kind of person who understood what marriage was before I was going to end one. I think it's because I didn't want the answer to what did I just do to be, I don't know. Thank you.